Bam! Mr. Taru, in this math lesson, we are going to be looking at four examples dealing with angle measures that are in the unit of measure of degrees, minutes, and seconds. Minutes and seconds are a part of a subdivision of a degree, like a decimal. And most of the work with angles in our trig book, unless you're working with unit circle problems and you have to memorize those 16 angles around the unit circle, are going to have these angles measured in what's called a decimal degree. But there will be a few, occasionally through the book, that are in a different unit of measure, with this DMS notation. Instead of having the part of an angle as a decimal, we'll break it down by minutes and seconds. And we have to know how to deal with that. So many angle measurements are not single whole number values. Now that I'm starting to read this, what is in this lesson? I'm going to have links, timestamps in this video's description, letting you skip ahead. We're going to do one example where we convert from decimal degrees to DMS, one other example where we work the other way around, DMS to decimal degrees, and then our last two examples are going to be addition and subtraction of angles when they're in this degree, minute, and second notation. Okay, so like centimeters are a part of a meter, and millimeters are part of a centimeter, a minute is a part of a degree, and the second is a part of a minute. So just taking these whole measurements of degrees and breaking them down more and more and more to increase sort of or decrease that measure of accuracy to get, well, sort of like a more accurate measurement of a particular angle. Now DMS notation, we got 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So if we're looking at minutes as being a part of a degree, there's 60 parts in a degree if those parts are number of minutes. And so thus 1/60th of a degree is equal to 1 minute. And this is the single little hatch mark here, or hash mark, whatever that's called. That is sort of a symbol for the word minutes. That's why I have this underlined in yellow. Well, I'm not sure how much different that's showing up on the camera. Maybe I should have picked a different color, but that's orange, that's yellow, and minutes, symbol notation, a single little hatch mark in the upper right-hand corner. Now, if breaking a degree down into 60 parts isn't, giving you an accurate enough measurement, you can then take those minutes and split them up again, and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 1/60th of a minute is 1 second. And so thus, 1 second is equal to 1/3600th or 1/3600th of a degree. Very, very minute parts of an angle measure. And maybe you need to break these degrees down into that small of an increment, maybe for astrology or, literally rocket science and some measurements like that that require a super precise unit of measure. Okay, so that means that if you want to convert from DMS notation, degree, minute, and seconds, to a decimal degree, more like we'd be used to with a calculator, we're going to take the number of degrees, that's going to be like the whole number value in the front, take the number of minutes and divide by 60, and then take the number of seconds and divide that by 3600 and add up those three values, and that is what we're going to use in our second example. But first, we're going to convert this decimal degrees to the unit of measure of degree, minutes, and seconds. We have 27.614 degrees. Okay, now let's see here. This is, of course, a whole number value. We have 27 degrees. And then we have this part of a degree, right? Well, that's what minutes are. It's a part of a degree. And there's 60 minutes in a degree, so really, I guess if I wanted to know how many minutes total, I could just do 27.614 and multiply by the whole thing by 60 and have this huge number of minutes. But, I don't want to break down, I don't want to have everything in terms of minutes. I have a nice whole number value here of 27 degrees. We're going to take the point, we're going to take and add a plus sign and take the 0.614. Make sure you take the decimal with it, this part of a degree, and we're going to break down into the next smaller unit of measure, which again, are those minutes. We're going to do that by doing 0.614 times 60. And when we do that, right off the top of my head, we have 27 degrees plus 0.614 times 60 is 36.84 minutes. And again, that's because 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. That's what's allowing me to do that conversion. Just like if you were taking the number of feet, a larger measurement, and you wanted it to be in number of minutes, or inches, you would multiply by 12. Taking a large measurement and finding out how many smaller parts are in there, like 12 inches and a foot, you would multiply by 12 to find inches and feet. And so thus we're taking 0.164, this part of a degree, and multiplying it by 60 so we can get the number of smaller units that are in that sort of larger unit of measure. So now, well, we have another decimal, and we did, of course, say that we can break minutes down even more by going into seconds. So we have a whole number of minutes. So now we're at 27 degrees and 36 minutes, but then we have an ability to go one more step and turn this 0.84 minutes into a number of seconds. Well, there, you know, are 60 seconds in a minute. So, and this is part of a minute. So we're going to do this breakdown again and do 0.84 times 60 again. And that's because, like I have written here, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. And that multiplication, again, right off the top of my head, comes out to be that, well, let's write the whole thing out, 27 degrees, 36 minutes, and then finally 0.86, well, that kind of is a little sloppy, 0.84 times 60 comes out to be 50.4 seconds. Now, we still have a bit of a decimal in there, but we're not going to break this angled measure down into any smaller units of measurements, anything smaller than seconds. So that is the end of my first example, and 27.614 degrees out of your calculator does come up to 27 degrees, 36 minutes, and 50.4 seconds. By the way, if you have a TI 83 or 84 in blue or yellow, depending on what calculator you have, above one of those buttons it says angle. So if you do second angle, you'll have a menu pop up, and one of those menus will have a little arrow in it that looks something like this, and it'll have DMS for degree, minute, seconds, and it'll do that conversion for you so you can check your answer. Now, I'm sure your teacher's going to want to see that work out, written out by hand, not just popped out of your calculator, but it is a nice way to check it if you're allowed to use your calculator during a quiz or, of course, during your homework to make sure you're doing these correctly. Don't practice these problems, not check your answer, and teach yourself how to do it the wrong way if your answers are incorrect. Make sure you check each one as you do the problems so you're practicing the right way. Now, we did this conversion from decimal degrees to DMS. Let's turn around. Convert this angle, which is in DMS format, degree, minute, and seconds, to decimals. Well, that example that I just erased, we had the decimal version. We multiplied by 60 to find the number of minutes, and the part of those minutes, we multiplied by 60 again to get the number of seconds. Now, I don't want to take my seconds and convert into minutes and then convert it into the degree measure, so I'm going to do, well, what I have up here. I'm going to take the degrees, leave it out front, just like I did with the other conversion. And I'm going to remember that the other way around, we multiplied, right? We're going from, to convert that decimal into DMS format. Well, now I've got this part, this 13 minutes, which is a very small measurement, right? It's 1/60th of a degree, because ultimately I just want a degree measure. So if I want to go from a really, really small measurement and get to a larger measurement, I need to what? Let's see here. Let's take, again, the inches and feet thing. If I have 24 inches, you know, those are small, relatively small units of length, and I want to convert number of inches to number of feet, which is a longer unit of measure, 24 inches is, 24 divided by 12 is 2 feet. So when you're going from a really small measurement to a larger unit of measure, you want to divide. And thus, I mean, I'm just trying to explain here why I'm taking the minutes and dividing by 60, besides the fact that it's just the opposite of what I did in the previous example. So, we're going to take 13 minutes, and we're going to divide that by 60, because there's 60 minutes in a degree, and so thus we're taking the number of minutes and dividing by 60, like I'm repeating what I just said a second ago. Now we're going to take the 42 seconds, and I want to go straight into degrees now, because I want to go right into the decimal format. So, I want to divide by 3,600, because again, and the other way around, we multiplied by 60 to get the parts into minutes, And then we multiply by 60 to get the part of a minute into a second. So multiplying by, you know, 60 times 60 is 3600. So going in the reverse order, we're dividing. All right, so that comes out to be, right off the top of my head, 125 plus 13 divided by 60 is equal to 0.21. Now this starts to repeat, and our final answer is going to be just a little bit off from where we started from. Because of this round-off error, we get this 0.6 repeating. So I'm going to just go to a few decimals there and then round up to 7. And then 42 divided by 3600, that comes out to be 0.011667. And putting that all together, we have approximately, and it is approximate. This is exactly 13 and this is exactly 42, but trying to convert into that decimal format, we have these run on decimals. And so our final answer is going to be close, but not exactly right. So it's approximately 125.2283 degrees. Now, if you put this into your graphing calculator and do second angle and hit that convert to DMS format, this is not going to get exactly back to this 125, 13 minutes and 42 seconds again because of that round off error. You can run these sixes a little bit farther out and you'll be closer. And that is how you convert from degree, minutes, and seconds to a decimal version measurement of an angle. Now, how do you add angles and subtract angles that are in this DMS format? Well, let's find out. No. Example 3. We're going to add 63 degrees and 41 minutes to 28 degrees and 34 minutes. Okay, well, you could also write this as 63 degrees and 41 minutes, if you prefer, and 28 degrees and 34 minutes. Only can't think of this sort of like the ones, tens, and hundreds columns because this isn't really base 10, it's base 60, because there's 60 minutes in a degree and another 60 minutes in a second, or 3600 seconds in a degree. So we're going to have to do a little like carryover type work, but it's going to be different because we're not base 10. So let's not worry about doing any carryover and actually just add these columns up, the degrees and the minutes, and see what we get. 41 plus 30 is 71, and 71 plus 5 is thinking of the answer. Let's try that again. 41 plus 30 is 71, and 71 plus 4 is 75 minutes. And we have 63 plus 20 is 83, and 83 plus 8 is going to be 91. Okay, so we have 91 minutes and 75 seconds. Well, you know, if you asked someone how tall they were, and they said, oh, you know, I'm 5 feet and 13 inches. You know, that doesn't make any sense. Like, why would you say 13 inches? You know, why don't you just say 6 foot and 1 inch, right? You don't, why would you have a part that's bigger than the whole? So that's what we need to worry about. You know, and so here, let's see, how can we do this? There's a few ways you could show this. You know, I could say, well, I'm going to subtract out 60 minutes, and which is going to give me 75 minutes, take away 60 minutes is going to be 15 minutes. But, you know, I can't just do that. I'm going to change the value of my answer. So, you know, if I take out a 60 minutes, I need to add back in an equivalent of 60 minutes, which is one degree. And thus our final answer is 90, I don't know why I put away over there, 92 degrees and 15 minutes. And there's other ways you could show that as well, but you know, by subtracting 60 minutes and adding in another degree, I'm taking away and adding an equivalent value, so I'm basically adding by zero, if you will. And I'm sure there's maybe some other notations that maybe your teachers will show to show that sort of taking out of the 60 and bringing in the extra one, but I hope that works for you. Find the complementary angle to 30 degrees, 15 minutes, and 40 seconds. Well, we have to understand what the definition means for complementary angles, and hopefully do from geometry. Complementary angles are two angles that add to 90, and supplementary angles, not that that's in this particular question, but supplementary angles are two angles that add up to 180 degrees. There's some vocabulary you need to know. And you know, I mean, you might know how to add and subtract angles that are in this DMS format, but if the question gives you some vocabulary you don't know what it means, you're not going to be able to get the question right. Do you know that that means they add up to 90? Well, so we're going to do 90. I hope so, otherwise you can't do the question. So we're doing 90 take away 30 degrees, 15 minutes, and 40 seconds. Well, you know, just like if we were doing regular subtraction, except, you know, we're not in base 10. If I was doing 200 minus, oh, I don't know, 9, I would need to borrow from the 2 and make this 10, and then I'll have to borrow from the 10 and add that over and make that make it a 9 and then bring a 10 over, or a 1 over for the hundreds, 10 units, and 1's place. But, you know, I'm borrowing and bringing over 10 because this is base 10 number system, and that would be, you know, 100 and, of course, 91, 10 minus 9 is 1, and you just bring the 9 and the 1 down. Well, we're not borrowing on a base 10, we're borrowing on base 60. So I'm going to just take this really, really small steps and say, well, I don't have anything to take the 15 minutes away. So let's borrow a degree and make that 89, and in its place, you know, take away a degree, let's add in a minute. But I'm getting a little bit sloppy here. So let's write that as 89 degrees and 60 minutes. Awesome. Well, now I don't have anything to borrow or subtract my 40 seconds from. So we need to borrow the minute, which is going to bring that down to 59 minutes, and add in, its equivalent, which is 60 seconds. But again, trying to keep this as neat as possible. Probably should use some different colors in here. How about we kind of just do this? This is bugging me a little bit. Right now you're hitting the fast forward button on the lesson. All right, so now bringing this over here, we have 89 degrees, and we have 59 minutes, and then we have 60 seconds, and we're taking away, finally now, we can do the subtraction of 30 degrees, 15 minutes, and 40 seconds. So our final answer is going to be 60 minus 40, which is 20 seconds. 59 minus 15, well, 59 minus 10 is 49, and 49 minus 5 is 44 minutes. And then finally, 89 minus 30 is going to be 59 degrees. And let me just make sure that I am green with my answer I've already gotten. Yes, I am, and that is how you deal with degree, minute, second notation, or DMS notation for angle measures of angles. I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework. With the remainder of two-fifths. I can't believe I'm pausing trying to write that answer out. So 7 divided by, oh, for good Lord.